Dillian Whyte has thrown shots at reigning WBC champion Tyson Fury, as if he fights the Gypsy King next. The question is, why, when he has a potential banana peel in front of him? Today, we're gonna delve into Dillian Whyte's next opponent, the Russian Alexander Povetkin, and why he should not be overlooked. Hey guys, this is Boxing Subjective Observer and welcome back to Ringside Stories. Feel free to like and share. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell if you enjoy the content. Now, I like Dillian Whyte a lot as a fighter. He's a character in boxing.
What if I go with my kid to Disneyland and he comes to the car? Are you mad?
A natural fighter, and although he looks a bit clunky at times, he possesses more abilities than some give him credit for. Sure, he doesn't have a signature win against an elite level fighter yet. Still, the Body Snatcher actually has a very good resume at the making of this episode. Probably the deepest resume, bar Anthony Joshua, which my 4-episode Villains Version series show. And in my opinion, Dillian Whyte has more than rightfully earned his shot at the WBC heavyweight world title. However, in the last week, Dillian Whyte has found the need to fire shots at reigning WBC champion Tyson Fury.
So I'm down. It's just whether or not Tyson Fury wants the smoke or not. You know, he says he's the Gypsy King. He fights any man, anywhere, this and the other. But when it comes to me, there seem to be some sort of stumbling block.
Now, I understand a lot has to do with staying relevant. There's an element of entertainment. And I'm sure Dillian Whyte really wants to fight the Gypsy King. Yet the question remains, why? Why put so much energy in a fight that's probably happening in 2021 at the earliest, if it does happen? As it stands, Tyson Fury is fighting Deontay Wilder for a third time, and Dillian Whyte has to defend his WBC interim title against Alexander Povetkin. Although the former WBA heavyweight world champion turns 41 this September, Povetkin is definitely not a fighter Whyte should overlook. And as the Body Snatcher himself stated,
Yeah, I never overlook fights. I just focus on the fight ahead because it's boxing, you know, it's boxing. I focus one fight ahead.
So today we're doing a reintroduction and 5 reasons why Dillian Whyte should be focusing on no one else but his next opponent, Alexander Povetkin. Number 1, experience. Before becoming the WBA regular world champion, Povetkin was the towering force in the amateurs at super heavyweight in the early 2000s. Following in the footsteps of Vladimir Klitschko, Povetkin was the 2003 amateur world champion and the 2004 Olympic gold medalist. His experience came into play against Ruslan Chagaev. Povetkin was losing the fight until his then trainer Teddy Atlas inspired Povetkin to turn the tides.
If we can bring your father back tonight,
we will bring him to us.
You know why? Because they're going to talk about his son, the new world champion.
Which effectively got the Russian winning the fight by unanimous decision and capturing the WBA regular world title. Povetkin also showed his moxie in his 2019 fight against legit top 10 contender Michael the Bounty Hunter. A fight I personally believe Hunter edged, but saw a crafty 40-year-old Povetkin do good work battling the near 10-year younger opponent to a draw. Number 2, traveling. After fighting in Germany for the majority of his early pro career, Povetkin has fought in Russia exclusively between 2013 and 2017. However, his last 4 fights were all on foreign soil, including 3 fights in the United Kingdom. By now, Alexander Povetkin is used to traveling and fighting abroad and will not be faced by giving up home court advantage. Also, Povetkin has shown throughout his career he doesn't need the crowd to enhance his performance. So with the fight most likely being behind closed doors on foreign soil, I personally don't think that will affect Povetkin's performance in the ring. Whereas Dillian Whyte does get energy fighting in front of a sold-out arena.
And yeah, I sent an email and the messages and phone calls when we got the official date for the garden job on the 22nd of August. And I didn't hear until I heard from Neil, the lawyer, and briefed me on the statement that Dillian was going to put out.
How will this new setting affect Dillian Whyte? Number 3. Power. Of Alexander Povetkin's 35 wins, 24 have come by way of stoppage. Since the Russian stands at 6'2" and is considered a quote-unquote small heavyweight for today's standards, Povetkin gives up the height and reach advantage against pretty much anybody in the division. Povetkin likes to apply pressure and dip underneath his opponent's shots, weaving his way inside where he does most of his work, mostly with short hooks and fast combinations. Povetkin possesses a mean left hook that forced a lot of opponents to touch the canvas. He was the first to stop 6'8" Polish heavyweight Mariusz Wach, the first to stop former IBF heavyweight title contender Carlos Takam, and has a TKO victory over Manuel Char, who currently holds the WBA regular world title. So even though Alexander Povetkin is past his prime, he is still dangerous, especially up close. On top of that, Povetkin doesn't mind going to war. Which brings us to reason number 4, fighting style. Derek Chisora posed stylistic problems for Dillian Whyte in both of their fights. Well, Alexander Povetkin is a more sophisticated and accomplished fighter than Derek Chisora. He beat plenty of guys who had the height and reach advantage over Povetkin, the likes of David Price, Yui Fury, and Mariusz Wach, who, unlike Whyte, Povetkin was able to stop. Even Anthony Joshua had some trouble with Povetkin, especially in the early rounds of their bout in 2018. As mentioned, Whyte went the distance against Mariusz Wach. Now, of course, Whyte was engaged in a legal battle, so his preparations surrounding that Wach fight by the end of 2019 were far from ideal. Still, Dillian Whyte came in at a career heaviest of 271 pounds, looked very sluggish in that Wach fight, which was evidence of Whyte's lack of discipline and focus. Dillian Whyte cannot lose focus against a 15-year pro in Alexander Povetkin. Number 5, durability. In his 15 years as a pro, Alexander Povetkin has lost twice and has only been stopped once by current unified champion Anthony Joshua. In his first loss against the then unified heavyweight champion Vladimir Klitschko, Povetkin got pushed around and leaned on for all of 12 rounds. And in my opinion, Vladimir Klitschko should have been disqualified in that Povetkin fight. Now officially, Povetkin did lose on points, but got hit with a truck full of Klitschko's punches. Say what you want to say about Vladimir Klitschko, but he's one of boxing's most technical heavyweights in history, meaning if he hits you flush, you got to be able to take a punch and recover well. Go ask Kubrat Pulev that. In Povetkin's most recent fight in December of 2019, Michael Hunter hit Povetkin with a lot of clean shots. Keep in mind, this was a 40-year-old Alexander Povetkin facing a near 10-year younger and fresher fighter in Hunter. Alexander Povetkin showed why he is still a top 10 heavyweight as of today and that he still has something left in the tank. By contrast, on the same card, apart from coming in heavily overweight, Dillian Whyte looked rather uninspired in his bout against Mariusz Wach. And if Whyte is not focused on the night he steps into the ring against Alexander Povetkin, the Body Snatcher could be in for a rude awakening. And with a fighter as experienced, accomplished, and dangerous as Alexander Povetkin is, Dillian Whyte would be wise to stop talking about his title shot against Tyson Fury and keep his eyes on the opponent that's in front of him next. Because we've all seen what happened to the last top heavyweight in the current era who was focusing on the fight after.
As I said, I'm willing to fight Deontay Wilder April 13th in London. So I don't know what more I have to do to get that message across.
As opposed to the fight that was right in front of them.
Ruiz comes to fire back and Joshua's hurt. Oh, Joshua goes down.
I'm done. I'm up to fight Tyson. I've already accepted a fight with him. You know, I've already been trying to fight Fury for a long time.
What are your thoughts? Should Dillian Whyte be more focused on Alexander Povetkin? Drop a comment below and let's have a conversation. Feel free to like and share. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell if you enjoy the content. This is Boxing's Objective Observer, Ringside Stories. Thanks for watching and have a legendary day.